Hello and welcome to Late Night Pens. Today I'm going to bring you my review of the new limited edition ink from Jacques Herbin. This ink was voted on at the start of the year from a selection of four different colours and released in October. This ink was released as a limited edition to commemorate the 350th anniversary of Jacques Herbin as a company. This ink is the Vert Atlantide or the Green Atlantis. Let's make a start.
So to start off, this is the box that the ink comes in. The Jacques Herbin box, and you've got the nice sticker on the top to indicate the colour and then some information on the back about the ink as well. Inside the box you also get an information leaflet which tells you a little bit about Jacques Herbin in both French and in English. And then here is the bottle itself. I think it looks very classy. You've got the nice faux wax seal on the front there. The seal sticker and the cap also match up with the colour of the ink on the inside. And in the bottom you can see where the shimmer settles as well. And then the opening for the neck, wide enough to fit any pen in there as well, no problems with that. So here is the ink first off on a sample card. You can see it's a really nice dark green ink with a kind of a grey undertone to it as well, and the silver and gold shimmer shows up quite subtly. It makes it look more like a champagne gold. And here it is compared to another green ink, which is Diamine's Green Umber, which is a similar kind of ink. It's slightly more green. This has a kind of a more muted green tone to it. First off, here is the ink on Rhodia's 80 GSM paper. You can see it's a nice dark green ink with a gold and silver shimmer. It's got a grey undertone to it as well, which kind of adds to the mysterious green colour. You can see there the shimmer in the light, which is quite nice. It's kind of subtle as it is silver and gold. It looks very nice in the light. In terms of wetness, it's quite a wet ink, which helps to bring out the shimmer, and it adds to the shading as well. It flows well, and this is nice ink to write with. The dry time is approximately 20 seconds on this paper. The shading, as you can see here, you go from a kind of a light mysterious green down to the dark colour as well. On this paper, there isn't any feathering and there's very little bleed through or ghosting as well. You can see on the other side here, you can just about make out where some of the text is, but not very much at all. And then for a test of the ink's waterproofing, there's a nice big spill on there. Leave it a couple of seconds. Now this isn't a waterproof ink, but that's quite a good performance really. You do lose the shimmer as that gets washed off, but the colour is still there and it's nice and legible still. I wouldn't worry too much about getting this ink slightly damp in the rain, for example. Next up, here's the ink on some laid writing paper. So it performs very similarly, it still performs very nicely I think. You've still got quite a nice wet flow. The dry time is a little bit quicker on this paper. You get a similar level of shading there, as you can see. And you also get very little feathering or bleed through and only a slight bit of ghosting as well. For the waterproofing on this paper, so the ink is still roughly legible there. It has washed off a little bit more than on the Rhodia pad, and again you do lose the shimmer effect as well. Overall this ink works quite nicely on the writing paper, and I'd say for letter writing it could be a very nice choice. And finally, here's the ink on some journal paper. So as the paper is a bit more absorbent, you do lose a lot of the wetness of the flow, but you do get a lot of dry time as well. It is drying very quickly. The shading, you don't get very much at all, again, due to the absorbentness of the paper. One of the downsides of this ink is on this paper, you get a lot of feathering and ghosting and bleed through. As you can see on the other side here, the ink does bleed through and you do get quite a lot of ghosting as well, which makes the paper on the other side hard to use. Compared to the Pelican ink I used in the last review, you don't get very much of that at all. So overall I'd say this paper is not very good for journal paper, but it is good for the other types of paper. Overall, I've said this is a really nice ink. It flows nicely, it dries reasonably quickly, and the subtle shimmer adds a nice touch of personality to your writing. I'd recommend you use this ink with a wet nibbed pen or a broad nibbed pen so you can get the shimmer and the shading to show out nicely. In particular, it looks good in the translucent or transparent pen as well, so if you have a demonstrator pen like a Twisby or like the Narwhal I've shown you earlier on, this ink would look really nice in there as well. As a side note for the cleaning, the colour itself comes out quite nicely, but you are left with a little bit of leftover shimmer, so I would recommend you put this in a pen dedicated to shimmer inks, or one that you don't mind having some leftover shimmer in your next writing. So to sum up, this ink has a really lovely colour with some nice shimmer and shading. It works really well and it flows nicely and dries reasonably quickly, and the presentation is excellent. On the downside, it performs poorly on journal paper or absorbent paper and is on the high end of the pricing scale. On balance, though, I do think the ink is worth the asking price.
That concludes today's video. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to leave me any suggestions or feedback in the comments section below and follow my Instagram page at Late Night Pens.